Welcome back to Paul's Tech News. This is a recap of all the most noteworthy and salient things that happened in the past week in the world of PC hardware. And there's actually a lot to cover today since we've just slogged through perhaps the launchiest week of this year's launch season, which saw the debut and subsequent dismissal of Intel's 14th Gen Core CPUs. But that's not all. AMD also revealed their Threadripper 7000 plans and set a November 21st launch date. Nvidia is having even more trouble with the feds, and they might have more RTX 40 series GPUs in store with a super dumb name. And the Anti-Lag Plus debacle has been solved with the removal of Anti-Lag Plus. Instead of turning it off and back on again, AMD just turned it off. But I'm not here to turn things off, my friends. I'm here to turn you on with the tech news.
Excellent!
Today's video is brought to you by Lexar's Thor OC DDR5 memory kits, powering the latest generation of desktop gaming and workstation PCs. Available in speeds up to 6,000 megatransfers per second with CL32 timings, and equipped with both XMP 3.0 and Expo support for Intel or AMD platforms, Lexar Thor OC DDR5 memory provides stability, reliability, and efficiency in a classy and elegant low-profile design. For more on Lexar's Thor OC DDR5 memory kits, click the sponsor link in the video description. We begin with a quick recap of the big news this week, which were both covered in further detail in the videos I posted about them, so check the description for links to those if you missed them. Intel's 14th Gen Core CPUs launched on Tuesday, the K models at least, and the 14900K, 14700K, and 14600K were tested quite thoroughly by the tech medias, who all seemed to be vaguely offended towards Intel for wasting all of our collective time. For you see, 14th Gen CPUs are not but 13th Gen CPUs after maybe a cup of coffee. They run at a bit higher frequency, but ultimately do about the same amount of work while being far less efficient, especially compared to AMD's Ryzen 7000 series of CPUs. They are certainly not generational improvements in terms of performance, and the 14th Gen moniker is just window dressing to sell CPUs to people who probably don't watch this YouTube channel. Almost as if to counter Intel's feeble performance Tuesday, AMD dropped an info dump Thursday, revealing and confirming their upcoming Threadripper 7000 series of workstation CPUs, which launch November 21st and include pro models that go up to 96 cores with the 7995WX and non-pro high-end desktop variants that go up to 64 cores with the 7980X. Prices are $1,500 for the 24-core 7960X, $2,500 for the 32-core 7970X, and $5,000 for the 64-core 7980X. They'll slot into socket STR5 motherboards with the WRX90 chipset for pro CPUs, or high-end desktop-oriented TRX50 chipset boards that support non-pro and pro CPUs, albeit with reduced PCIe connectivity and DDR5 channels. No info on pricing for those pro models yet, so I can't advise you on how many of your kidneys you'll need to sell in order to pick up a 7995WX, but AMD did confirm that the Threadripper 7000 Pros will also be available as standalone CPUs directly from e-tailers, as well as via pre-built workstations from system integrators. And then there's Nvidia, who remains in the news not because of new GPUs launching or yet another retro game that they updated with ray tracing, but because the products they make are seen as existential threats to our national security if too many of them get into the wrong hands, or so the United States Department of Commerce indicated when they announced new export restrictions on AI chips on Tuesday. We can't let China have better AI than us, is what it boils down to, although new license requirements will apply to 40 additional countries as well, countries that might be too buddy-buddy with China, and who will therefore have to rely on actual intelligence instead of the artificial kind for now. And while the goal of the US restrictions is to prevent Chinese access to advanced semiconductors that could fuel breakthroughs in artificial intelligence, especially with military uses, the updated restrictions now mean that even Nvidia's RTX 4090 and systems based on it can't be sent to China or the other countries affected, at least not without going through the US government for a license. Now, Nvidia had already worked around federal restrictions imposed last year, which specifically targeted chip-to-chip transfer rates by introducing their H800 and A800 AI processors, with nerfed interconnects to slip in under the limits that were imposed. But Tuesday's updates, which go into effect November 16th, now restrict shipments of Nvidia's A100, A800, H100, H800, L40, and L40S chips, and yes, the RTX 4090 too. And yes, this would also affect chips from competitors like Intel and AMD, but they're not quite as up to speed as Nvidia in this space just yet. Certainly there are many facets to this story, but I couldn't help but think it must be really hard to be a PC gamer in China, abiding by the social credit system, dealing with censorship and draconian restrictions on playtime for younger gamers, and now foreign governments are banning the best gaming GPUs from the country. They just can't catch a break. Speaking of the Nvidia RTX 4090, and who knows if this is coincidence or not, but they appear to be more scarce these days if you're actually looking to buy one at the $1,600 MSRP. Tom's Hardware has been tracking pricing since June, and while there are models to be had for $1,650, the upward trend in pricing is a bit concerning. Nvidia was already said to have limited or halted RTX 40 series production earlier this year due to lack of demand, or to shift focus over to AI chips, or perhaps both. And a couple weeks ago, severe RTX 4090 shortages were reported in Japan, which aren't as severe as, say, food or water shortages, but almost. Nvidia also might be working on a mid-gen refresh for the RTX 40 series, if Twitter informant Hongxing 2020 is to be believed, with a 4080 Super, 4070 Ti Super, and 4070 Super proposed, along with a TBD launch date. And as much as I dislike the super name that Nvidia first used with the RTX 20 series, I must also consider that at least they didn't just call it the RTX 50 series, which is probably what Intel would have done. Positioning of super class cards is also made more confusing by the existence of Ti branding, and now that there might be an RTX 4070 Ti Super, my mind is truly blown. If this rumor does pan out, I would speculate that these new cards launch in Q1 or Q2 of 2024. Here's one more rumor to ruminate upon. AMD's Ryzen 8000 series will likely launch at some point, and the other Paul from Red Gaming Tech claims to have Cinebench 2024 scores for an engineering sample flagship 8950X. Those scores are 2,400 points for multi-core and about 140 points for single-core, which would place it ahead of every other CPU on the market, pretty much, including the 14900K, and also beating the Threadripper Pro 5965WX by 5% in the multi-threaded test. We're expecting that Ryzen 8000 series CPUs will be 4-nanometer Zen 5-based chips, and they'll likely be announced in the first half of 2024. I think technically that last story could have been included here in tech briefs, but coming early should be forgiven whether you do it in your briefs or not, I say. You might have missed AMD's other launch news this week, which was on the mobile GPU side and somewhat overshadowed by Threadripper 7000. The Radeon RX 7900M debuted Thursday and can be purchased now in a Dell Alienware M18 laptop. It's notably the first laptop GPU to use a chiplet design and is expected to compete with Nvidia's RTX 4080 mobile GPU in terms of performance. It is 7% faster, says AMD, at 1440 at least, according to their tests across a bunch of games. And if we head over to the Dell website for the Alienware M18, it also seems to be about 150 bucks cheaper than the RTX 4082, at least per Dell's pricing. There was a small media event for Threadripper 7000 announcements at AMD headquarters, and a couple news bits have come of it. First, PC Mag already has posted early benchmarks of the 96-core flagship Threadripper 7995WX, since they were sent a Dell Precision 7875 workstation for review. They were able to confirm AMD's announcement benchmarks. The 7995WX appears to be 58% faster than the last gen 5995WX and 80% faster than Intel's nearest competing CPU, the 56-core Xeon W9-3495X. Also at the event, media outlet QuasarZone snapped some pics of the Threadripper OC demo, which they posted and then took down, but not before those pictures were scooped up by videocards.com, showing a liquid nitrogen overclock of 4.4 GHz across all 96 cores, 620 watts of power being drawn, and a world record score of 148,719, beating the previous record, which was set by a dual Epic rig. The only truly sad part is the price, which is still unconfirmed, but Video Cards thinks it'll be 10 grand. I wonder if AMD will be able to import them to China. More Threadripper stuff? Okay, it's a socket STR5 motherboard this time, which we haven't seen many of, but here's the Gigabyte TRX50 AERO DSP6. TRX50 boards have quad channel DDR5 support, hence the 4 RDIMM slots, and with such a big socket, I wonder how many STR5 motherboards will go with a 90 degree rotated orientation like this one. 16 plus 8 plus 4 phase VRM, dual 8 pins for supplemental CPU power, which is pretty normal, 3 PCIe Gen 5.0 by 16 slots, and 4 M.2 Gen 5 by 4 slots, which should allow you to use up all your lanes depending on how they're populated. A nice looking design from Gigabyte, but how much will it cost? We don't know. A lot. A really lot. Here's a follow-up to AMD's Anti-Lag Plus woes last week, as that part of the Radeon driver suite was found to trigger anti-cheat software in multiple titles, including CSGO, resulting in quite a few account bans, some of them high profile. AMD, for their part, fixed the problem by taking down the offending driver and replacing it with version 23.10.2, which just removes Anti-Lag Plus support completely, so there. Fixed. Now that feature we just launched is unlaunched. If Nvidia can unlaunch stuff, we can too, says AMD. Fortunately, Valve has taken action too, working to reverse bans caused by running Anti-Lag Plus, and also patching CSGO so the game will check what AMD driver is being used before banning the account. And I hate to say it, but as someone who regularly recommends AMD GPUs because they offer better value, it's stuff like this that causes people to still buy GeForce. Nvidia Reflex has not, to my knowledge, caused anyone to be banned from a game just by being there. Lastly, I wanted to show you guys this quirky little motherboard, which includes a CPU. It's a micro ATX motherboard with a B760M chipset built by Chinese manufacturer Airying. It will ship with a mobile 13th gen CPU pre-installed, up to the Core i9-13900H, and they de-lid the CPU so it can be cooled with an integrated vapor chamber cooler. So while the BGA socket does not allow for CPU upgrades, you can still add your own DDR4 RAM and a GPU or other expansion cards via the PCIe 4.0x8 slot or the PCIe 3.0x4 slot. It's a unique low-power crossover between mobile and desktop parts. I just wish there was a price listed. Why are there no prices for anything today? I bet this would make a great HTPC. But there you have it, guys, tech news for the week, and if you liked it, click that like button or leave me a comment down below. While you're down there, all of the articles I talked about today are linked in the video's description if you're interested, and you can check out my store at paulshardware.net for high-quality merchandise, t-shirts, hoodies, beer sets, and more. Subscribing to my channel is always a good call too. Thanks again, everyone, and we'll see you next week.